Roy's the only DLC character I haven't covered, so I guess it's about time. The format of this video will be the same as the Fox combos in neutral video. I'm gonna cover the basic combos Roy can pull off. Then afterwards, at about the 4 minute and 30 second mark, I'll be interviewing Ryo, one of the best, if not the best Roy player, where he'll share his insight on Roy's neutral game. Let's start off with throw follow-ups. At really low percents against heavy and medium weights, when you land a grab, you can forward throw into a neutral air. Fast fall as soon as you can, then go for another neutral air. Fast fall it once more and you can link one last neutral air. From low to mid percents, against the same weight classes, forward throw into side B if they DI away, and a neutral air if they DI towards you. Against light characters, down throw to neutral air. And fast fallers, down throw to side B at very low percents, and down throw to neutral air as the percent rises. Once your opponent enters the high percent range, Roy can set up a frame trap situation. After a down throw, go for a forward air. If they try to attack or jump, they'll get hit. If they air dodge, the forward air will miss, but immediately fast fall, then punish their landing lag. An easy punish would be a forward tilt or up air. But if you're in the right position, you can go for the first hit of neutral air into an up B, or smash attack, which may be able to kill. Next up, we have Roy's jab. This move comes out quite fast. At low to mid percents, heavy and medium weights follow up with side B. From mid to high percents, go for a neutral air. At really high percents, against light and heavy weights, you can connect an up B. If you land a raw short hop forward air, you can combo into side B at these percentages, and an up B at higher percentages. An important thing to know is that whenever you do Roy's short hop forward air, you'll lag on landing, but if you input a jump or any of his specials right before you land, you can negate the lag. Another move with high combo potential is neutral air. To start off, the first hit of neutral air can lead into a jab, then side B against heavy and fast fallers. Since their character model will be higher up after the jab, it's probably best to go for the upwards variation. Unfortunately, lighter characters get popped up too high, so just go for a side B. Percents any higher than this, you can link an up B. If you cancel the neutral air very early, provided you're really close to your opponent as well, it's possible to link an up smash. The second hit of Roar's neutral air has pretty good range, and can combo into a short hop neutral air. Fast fall it into a forward air, then up B. This works at low percents for medium and heavy weights. As for lightweights and fast fallers, you can actually grab them after, then down throw into another neutral air. Percents a bit higher against heavy and medium weights, go for another neutral air. Around these same percentages, there's a frame trap opportunity for lightweights and fast fallers. After the second hit of neutral air, go for a forward air. If they air dodge, you can side B them on landing. If they do anything else, they'll likely eat the forward air. Moving on to Roy's down tilt. Although it doesn't have any true follow-ups, it'll start making the opponent tumble at about 50% with no rage, in which case you can chase them with a dash attack, provided they miss their tech. Roy's falling up air puts your opponent in a very nice position to combo. At low percents against medium and heavyweights, you can pull off a footstool lock combo. After the up air, footstool then fast fall up back air. Aim to hit the edge of the sword so that you land the sour spot. If done correctly, they should be locked. Follow up with two neutral airs. Against light and fast fallers, go for a jab, then side B, at about 0 to 20%. Reaching higher percents against heavies, follow up with a forward air, then up B, in a neutral air or up air against the rest. As you probably already know, in contrast to Marth, the power of Roy's sword comes from the base, though the edge of the sword definitely has its uses too. A sour up air can lead into a jab at these percents. Any percents higher, go for an up B. Sour forward air sends the opponent on a low trajectory at around low mid percents. If they miss their tech, you can double jump then fast fall neutral air into forward air, then an up B. Similarly, sour jab works the same way. At really high percents, it'll start forcing the opponent into a low tumble trajectory, in which case if they miss their tech, you can run up and punish with dash attack. So that's it for Roy's combos. Now Ryo is going to share with you how Roy should be played in the neutral. Welcome Ryo. So the first question I have for you is, what is a good way to play Roy in neutral? Is he best when played aggressively, defensively, or a mix of the two?
I would say a mix of the two, because with Roy's neutral, you're going to be trying to get out a lot of jabs, a lot of neutral airs, a lot of fairs, and especially first hit and air. Which first hit and air can be used as an aggressive option, but it can also be used as a very defensive option. Because when you throw out for a sitting air on shield and someone doesn't respect it, you can get off a free jab or an up B, which is really, really good. Or down smash, because that move is extremely fast and really good at punishing. Myself, personally, people think I play very aggressive, but I want to tell everyone, hush, hush, secret, secret, I actually play very passive. Like, I just move a lot to confuse my opponent, because I don't want them to think everything that I'm doing.
All right, let's move on to the next question. What are some effective ways to approach with Roy?
This is the hard part. This is the part that a lot of people, I guess a lot of Roys need to understand. Roy's approaching options are not great. They're actually pretty bad at times. Whenever I approach with Roy, like I said, I like to do a lot of empty hops, which then conditions my opponent to believing either I'm going to throw out an aerial or I'll go for like a grab. I can mix it up between the two. But Roy's approaches are actually pretty bad on shield. Like if I throw out a fair on shield, I get punished. I throw off a both hits of Nair, I get punished. Anything I throw on shield is punishable. So what you have to do as a Roy main or Roy player in general is that you have to bait. You have to bait. So approaching is literally put into your opponent's mind. Because like when people play me, they think of first and air is going to come. So I'm like, okay, they expect this. So they're going to spot dodge. If they do, I can always wait to do like an approach option or an aggressive option and get like a grab. Because Roy's grab combos are actually pretty good at low percents and mid percents. So you want to try and mix up on shield a lot, because first and air on shield as a mix-up is really, really powerful because it's so fast. So if someone tries to punish you and you cross up their shield, they're doing something usually in the wrong direction, which that means you can either turn around, grab, jab, or anything else off of it, which is really, really good for Roy because you have to be able to use his speed to its utmost ability. That's the thing a lot of Roys aren't doing properly, I feel, is that they're not using his speed for what it's intended to do, I feel like, in the current meta, which is for cross-ups and really good fake-outs.
Okay, so the third question is, how should Roy recover back on stage?
Roy should recover back on stage based upon the character that he's playing against position. You should not try to, every time, attack with a B, even though it's a really good disjoint. Like, whenever I played Abadongo, he would come after me, and when I noticed he was coming after me, I would up B. Before he like tried to guess where I was going to be, I'm like, forget it. I would prefer just to be up really high and fast fall to the ground because Roy's recovery is very exploitable and you don't want to be in that position trying to recover against characters like Mewtwo or Pikachu or Corrin or anybody. Like anybody with a counter literally destroys Roy. So it's best to recover high, unlike the other Fire Emblem characters if you want to recover low.
All right. The next question is, what are some of Roy's strengths and weaknesses?
Roy's strengths is that his speed and the amount of strength that he has, they're all, I hate to use this word, it's almost like, for me, kind of broken because he's so quick and he can kill you really fast. The biggest things for him, like I said before, were like mix-ups. His mix-ups are crazy. His neutral game like is weak, but once you get in on your opponent is smothered. You get absolutely smothered and they don't know what to do. I played against Larry Lerner at a Zero Saga, and he told me, he's like, I felt like once you hit me, I didn't have an option. Like, it was just hit after hit after hit. You know, that's his biggest strength, is that when Roy is in there, he's in there. He's all about being in your face. Like, if he's playing defensive, once he's in your face, the aggression should start immediately. But his biggest weakness is that his approach game is very weak, and his offstage game is very weak also. When people start catching on to first hit nairs, you almost lose an option to kill. But like, his kill setups off jab are pretty okay, and up B also comes off of jab. But the thing is, those are all set up off of his jab, and a lot of players are not going to be within the sweet spot range for you to actually hit them. They're trying to outspace you. Like, Roy gets outspaced really bad. If you play outside his range of sweet spots, he can't do much. Like, oh, his sour spots aren't that bad, but they're not bad. They're just not fantastic when it comes out of getting kills that you actually need. So I have to, like, make up by using my speed and the mix of options of first air fair or just normal neutral air. So I have to, like, again, mix them up. And that's a weakness within the meta because, like, in this metagame, it's not so much mix-ups. It's the guarantees and what mechanics your character has in their possession. And Roy is a very somewhat basic swordsman. So that he doesn't really have a lot of special things to throw to the table. But what he does have can be used in a very strong setting if you do it properly.
Interesting. So the next question is going to be about stages. What's a good counterpick stage for Roy?
For Roy, it would be Battlefield's really good. Smashville's fantastic because you can seriously Odeath Rosa on Smashville. If you follow the platform, You can nair her twice. If she goes up high, you nair her again, and you can follow up nair fair off stage. Another really good stage would be like Dreamland is really good because he doesn't die as easy. So when he gets launched off, he has a better chance of recovering because he just float back. So he's just, it's all good for him. Like shorter stages, Roy's not heavy, so he dies quick. FD is really, really good if you're playing like heavy or fastball characters because you can combo them a lot longer without them having the option of landing on a platform. So like platform games are really good for Roy, but against fastballers, you're like, I don't actually need to use them. I could just hit them here, and then they have to deal with all this pressure coming their way. They have nowhere to run. I've actually found out that Lilat's really good for Roy. It's kind of weird. The perfect height for up smash. Really good for Pokemon.
Okay, so now that we know what stages are good, what is Roy's strongest matchup, and what's his worst?
Oh boy, this is hard. Because I have very awkward opinions about my characters. I feel like a lot of the characters that I play have a lot better matchups than people actually say they do. One of his worst, Corrin makes me really upset because she just calls him for days. Since I have to use the base of my sword or the hilt or handle, she's like, I'm just throw out an attack. A really good matchup is Little Mac. I feel like Mewtwo is like a 50-50-ish, same thing like Rosa. I played against Komo Akiri at Zero Saga. Cloud is 55-45 in Cloud's favor. It's not huge. Yeah, it's very doable. I also feel like a Fox is probably like 55-45. These are matchups that people think are horrible for the character, but I'm like, no, there's no way. People just aren't exploring what Roy can actually do, which is apply the pressure, but also be very safe with what he's doing. Poke as much as you can, but once you get the hit, keep going. Roy also beats Ike, I think 55-45 or 6-4 at the most. And I put against an Ike, and I 3-0'd him real quick, because I'm like, this matchup is bad. Like, Roy, like Ike has to start, has all this startup lag, and Roy's just like, that's funny, I'm just going to attack you. But yeah, Roy has, against higher tier characters, it's not so bad. Like, Zero Suit's not bad, Cloud isn't bad. I don't feel like Sheik's that bad. I feel like that matchup maybe 55-45 in Sheik's favor. It's not too awful.
Alright, now for controls. What control scheme is best for Roy, in your opinion? Do you think there's an optimal control scheme, or does it depend on the player's playstyle?
I would say the only thing you really need to have as a controller setup for Roy is to have your C-stick set to tilt. That's the number one thing. Anything else you can have, but if you don't have your C-stick set to attack, you're already messing up what Roy needs as a character.
Okay, so now for the last question. You kind of covered it lightly as well before, but what do you think of Roy as a character in the current metagame?
I feel like Roy is probably from the top 25, I want to say.
Definitely viable, you'd say?
Yes, he's very viable. He's very, 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 very viable. He just needs a lot of love. You just got to practice with him. Don't, not just give up on him like everybody else does. So that's what I would say you should do.
Okay, Ryo, thank you so much for spending time sharing your knowledge on Roy with everyone. Really appreciate it.
Thank you. I'm happy. I can't wait to actually watch your video, to be honest. I'm really excited.
Guys, please show Ryo some love and follow him on his Twitter, YouTube, and Twitch. The links are here on the screen and in the description. And sorry it's been so long since my last upload. I was working on another video alongside this one, so my upload schedule should be back to normal from here on. And again, thanks a lot for my Patreons for your support. Ryan Lockwood, Sylveon Bay, Brooke Miad, Ethan Stevenson, Austin Lau, Ahmed Alois, and many others. And thank you everyone else for watching. I'll see you all in the next video.